On the sultry morning of August 22, 1963, test pilot Joe Walker was strapped into the X-15, a machine designed to shatter all speed records, preparing to blaze through the stratosphere at a jaw-dropping 4,520 miles per hour. Just a decade earlier, the F-86D Sabre, then the swiftest aircraft in the sky, had set a global record at 698 miles per hour. Today, Walker was gearing up to eclipse that record sevenfold. Closer to a missile than an aircraft, the X-15 was notorious as one of the most perilous ventures in aviation. Armed with the colossal XLR-99 liquid propellant engine, capable of delivering a devastating 57,000 pounds of thrust, every test flight teetered on the razor's edge of disaster. Pilots like Walker, pushing the very boundaries of speed and altitude, donned spacesuits to survive near-orbital flights and the fiery gauntlet of reentry. To prevent a catastrophic failure, NASA capped Walker's ascent at 400,000 feet, a ceiling meant to save his life. A mere 1,500 pounds of excess thrust could hurl him into the void of space, turning his high-speed reentry into a lethal inferno. Catapulted skyward at speeds rivaling an intercontinental ballistic missile, Walker was oblivious to the historic threshold he was about to cross. Then, in a heartbeat, the awe-inspiring curve of Earth and the unfathomable darkness of space sprawled before him. Pilot Joseph A. Walker was one of the select few airmen with a shot to helm the fastest man-made bird in the skies. The stakes were sky-high. Each flight flirted with the possibility of bursting into a fireball mid-air. The X-15 test flight program stood as a towering mid-20th century aerospace feat, demanding pilots of unmatched skill and iron nerves. Only the best were tapped for the X-15 program, aces from the US Air Force and Navy, seasoned in wrangling experimental jets and high-performance screamers. Beyond ace flying skills, these pilots were put through the ringer with tough physical and psychological screenings to ensure they could handle the brutal physical strains and lightning-fast decisions that were needed at the edge of space. A hefty dose of engineering savvy was crucial too, arming them to get deep into the X-15's intricate systems and troubleshoot on the fly. Walker first cut his teeth with the Army Air Forces during World War II as a weather reconnaissance pilot. Post-war, he joined the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, or NACA, as an experimental physicist, and soon became a civilian test pilot. By 1951, Walker was assigned to the Edwards Flight Research Facilities, stepping up as chief research pilot. He piloted a slew of aircraft, including the Bell X-1, two models of the Douglas D-55B Skyrocket, the Douglas X-3 Stiletto, the Northrop X-4 Bantam, and the Bell X-5. In 1958, Walker transferred to the X-15 program as NACA transitioned into the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA. Walker's debut X-15 flight on March 25, 1960, marked NASA's first ever mission. By the summer of 1963, he had commanded the craft 23 times, proving his mettle repeatedly. But no matter how many times he did it, piloting the X-15 was always a life or death adventure. Walker had to master control at blistering speeds of Mach 6 and altitudes brushing the fringes of space, over 50 miles above Earth. His problem-solving skills were tested relentlessly as he tackled in-flight glitches and breakdowns, which were all in a day's work, given the X-15's trailblazing nature. The risks were colossal. Blasting through the atmosphere at Mach 6 meant even minor slips could be catastrophic. The intense aerodynamic heating at these velocities could threaten the craft's structural integrity. The extreme altitudes pose hazards like cabin depressurization and unfamiliar radiation levels. Although equipped with an escape system, its reliability was questionable under some conditions, turning every emergency into a potential death trap. Moreover, the intense G-forces could disorient or knock out a pilot during aggressive maneuvers, adding yet another layer of peril to the death-defying flights. However, risks came with the territory when your job was to strap yourself to what was practically a giant rocket with no more than 90 seconds of fuel. Creating such a dangerous and bold aviation contraption was an ambitious gamble to stride forward in both hypersonic flight and space exploration. As the clouds of the Cold War grew darker, NACA teamed up with the Air Force and Navy to spearhead the X-Series program. This groundbreaking initiative aimed to shatter the known limits of aviation. The crown jewel of this venture was the X-15, a hypersonic superplane designed to breach the skies faster than Mach 6 and ascend to staggering altitudes beyond 46 miles high. If humanity were to ever reach the stars, the X-15 would be the first step in that direction. Standing 50 feet long and tipping the scales at about 33,300 pounds at launch, the X-15 was no ordinary plane. It boasted distinctive trapezoidal wings stretching over 20 feet. It was equipped with cutting-edge vertical and horizontal stabilizers derived from meticulous NACA research. These features not only gave the X-15 its iconic arrow-like silhouette, but also ensured it remained master of the skies, even when the thin air and extreme altitudes made conventional flight controls obsolete. The heart of this massive dart was the XLR-99 engine, a powerhouse burning through 19,000 pounds of liquid anhydrous ammonia and liquid oxygen. At altitudes where the air was too thin for standard aerodynamics, the X-15 relied on its innovative hydrogen peroxide-fueled jets on the nose and additional thrusters on the wingtips to maintain control and attitude. The X-15's maiden journey, an unpowered glide, was launched from a carrier aircraft on June 8, 1959. It was soon followed by its first powered sortie on September 17th. The real milestone came on November 15, 1960, with the X-15's first flight using the XLR-99 engine, and where Walker took control of the experimental aircraft. The third X-15 flight, piloted by none other than future space legend Neil Armstrong, occurred on December 20, 1961. Robert M. White etched his name into the annals of aviation history on July 17, 1962, by becoming the first pilot to earn astronaut wings aboard the X-15. On that groundbreaking flight, White piloted the aircraft to a breathtaking altitude of 314,750 feet, approximately 59.6 miles high, skirting just below the Kármán line, which marks the recognized boundary of space at 62 miles above sea level. Equipped with an Advanced Reaction Control System, or RCS, the X-15 was uniquely prepared for the challenges of near-space environments. This system enabled precise maneuvering at altitudes where conventional aerodynamic control surfaces, such as rudders and ailerons, would falter due to the thin atmosphere. Thanks to the RCS, pilots like White and Walker could maintain control and navigate effectively at the very edge of space, affirming the X-15's pivotal role in expanding the boundaries of human flight. Despite receiving his astronaut wings, White had not broken the Kármán line, so technically, reaching space on the X-15 was still up for grabs. The directors of the X-15 program set their sights high for flights number 90 and 91, aiming to test the aircraft's capabilities at an astonishing altitude of 360,000 feet, well above the Kármán line, defined by the International Aeronautical Federation as the boundary between Earth's atmosphere and outer space at 330,000 feet. Flight number 90, slated for July 19, 1963, tasked pilot Joe Walker with surpassing Robert White's prior achievements. The plan was for the X-15's engine to ignite for 83 seconds, propelling Walker to a peak speed of Mach 5.4 and an altitude of 314,961 feet. Alongside these feats, Walker was to deploy a special balloon to measure air density, while other onboard experiments included an ultraviolet phonometer to gauge Earth's background radiation, and an infrared phonometer to analyze the aircraft's exhaust signature. Launching from Edwards Air Force Base, the mission commenced with the X-15 secured under a modified B-52 bomber. At 10:19 a.m. local time, surrounded by chase aircraft, the X-15 was released over Smith Ranch Lake. However, an unexpected twist occurred. The engine fired for 84.5 seconds instead of the planned 83, and the ascent trajectory was 0.5 degrees steeper than intended. These slight deviations had a dramatic impact. The X-15 not only reached a speed of Mach 5.5, approximately 3,710 miles per hour, but also soared to an unexpected peak of 347,800 feet, overshooting the mission's target ceiling by 31,200 feet. This put Walker, technically, into space, marking him as the first civilian to achieve this feat. After an exhilarating 11 minutes 25 seconds of free flight, Walker skillfully navigated the X-15 through reentry and made a safe landing in Rogers Dry Lake, back at Edwards Air Force Base, capping off a mission that went beyond the high expectations set by its ambitious planners. On August 22, 1963, Joe Walker sealed himself into the cockpit of the X-15 for another flight verging on space exploration. His mission, number 91, ambitiously targeted the staggering altitude of 360,900 feet, attempting to push beyond the boundaries of Earth's atmosphere and into the realm of space. The flight plan was meticulously designed, featuring an engine burn of 84.5 seconds, aimed to propel him towards a top speed of Mach 5.38. Despite the hurdles of problematic technical issues and adverse weather causing three aborted attempts over 2 weeks, the final liftoff was a masterpiece of timing and endurance. As the rocket engine surged, Walker's skills were put to the ultimate test, navigating a flight path where each second of engine burn and slight deviation in climb angle could dramatically alter his ascent by thousands of feet. The safety ceiling set by NASA was 360,000 feet to accommodate unexpected variations, ensuring reentry from beyond 400,000 feet, a zone fraught with peril, remained uncharted. Surging upward, the engine's fuel was depleted at 176,000 feet, yet the X-15, now a mere projectile governed by the laws of physics, continued its ascent at a staggering speed. It climbed to an astonishing 354,200 feet, crossing the Kármán line and breaking every record achieved so far with the X-15. There, before Walker, sprawled the awe-inspiring curvature of Earth against the unfathomable darkness of space. For a brief, heart-stopping moment, as he glanced at his quickly ascending altimeter, Walker feared he had overshot, breaching the dangerous threshold of 400,000 feet, where the fiery forces of re-entry could potentially incinerate the aircraft and its occupant. Thankfully, his altitude remained within the bounds of safety, and he had indeed broken all previous records without compromising his return. The descent was as breathtaking as the climb. Walker steered the X-15 through a high-speed re-entry, expertly managing the forces that wrestled to reclaim the aircraft back to Earth. At 95,000 feet, he executed a high G-force pullout, stabilizing the craft at 70,000 feet for the final glide home. The X-15 kissed the surface of Rogers Dry Lake in a flawless landing, concluding an 11-minute, 8-second journey that shattered altitude records and confirmed Joe Walker's status as a pioneering astronaut. This historic flight underlined the capabilities of the X-15 program, which continued to challenge the frontiers of aerial and space travel, granting astronaut wings to five more brave pilots. Tragically, Joe Walker's illustrious career was cut short in 1966, but his legacy endured, crowned posthumously with astronaut wings. His dual ascents into space remained unmatched for decades, and the X-15 program was a pivotal asset in providing research data and experienced astronauts for the incoming Apollo program that would soon put a man on the moon.